Look at the left stalk. If you have the read button, it means you are able to read a little bit if there are problems or codes with the modules inside the car. Some of these modules are pretty important because they are pretty expensive to repair, so you want to know about them. So start with a blank display, make sure there's nothing on it. Keep this guy depressed and then depress two times quickly on it, on the fog button. If it doesn't work, just try to go slower or faster until you get that that message on the display. It didn't work. Let's try it again. Let's just try it again. It's really a matter of speed, actually. Sometimes it works, sometimes it's not, but just it's really a matter of just trying a different speed, actually. These are the codes. I will perhaps get you through my codes, the codes I have in my car already, but I will just point out the most important one, and in the video description below you'll notice there is a I'll put a list with all the codes. Again, you it's not the code itself, the number, but it's just that a module has a code. That's all you get this way, right? So you need to have still a reader to get the codes correctly. Obviously SRS, okay, one thing is that you notice there is a module, that's the name of the module or the computer, and then you have something said here. Ready means it's okay, there is no code to it. The other thing, let me just see, checking means it doesn't know already, it has to perform some check. Those checks, for some modules you need to drive the car, the car needs to be in movement. I'll give you an example for the brake module one. And finally, set S, if you see SET, it means there is a code for that module, so maybe you need a reader to get the code, to know which code it is. The way to scroll to this is just press on the read button to get through those modules. So let's just keep pressing SRS. It's pretty important, but obviously not obviously. Usually the SRS codes, when you see an SRS airbag on a car you want to buy, most of the time is just because someone maybe disconnected the radio. All these modules are connected together, and just Google up a little bit. I don't want to go too deep into that, but it's not necessarily a problem with the SRS system itself, but you need VIDA dice to erase that code. So let's just keep going. TCM, that's the throttle control, no, that's transmission message channel module. I'm not sure what exactly it is. I think it's perhaps related to the valve body on the transmission. This one says checking, so I guess you need to drive the car to a certain speed. I don't know the procedure to get that code, not that code, but that module checked fully and know if you have code or not for it. Let's just keep going on. ACM, I have a paper here, but I don't know what it is. Let's keep going. AUM, I don't know what it is. CEM, that's pretty important, actually. It means I have a code on CEM, but my car actually works pretty nice. But especially on 2004 and up, 2004, 2005, and also some XC90, they have a recall. There could be that CEM, it's a computer, big computer underneath the dashboard, and the water can start leaking on it, and you need to refurbish it. So it's pretty important if you have this code, not on my car, but if you are looking for a 2004-2005 S60 V70, you may want to negotiate the price, right? So it's fixable, but it's not ideal. Let's keep going on. DIM, that's the driver's information module, goes bad on 2002, 2003, and maybe 2001 as well. Mine was already repaired. DDM, I don't know what it is. I don't have DT here. CCM, that's the climate control module. It says I have a code for it. It does work fine, but those climate modules sometimes get glitchy. You may want to recalibrate them, or there's something not going on very well with them, but mine works. But hey, PDM, I don't know what it is, PSM nader. REM, this is the rear electronic module. That's a panel with fuses in the trunk, on the left side of the trunk. Usually it takes care of the several electric things, doors, rear doors, trunk, I think brake lights, stuff like this. I know one of my rear doors was replaced, so maybe that's why it's set. Not sure about this guy here, neither this one. All right, I think I skipped one. I skipped the BCM brake control module. Let me just try to activate it again. All right, DTCS. Okay, so this is the BCM brake control module. I think it's related also to ABS and stuff. Could be a repair actually, if you have a code for it. But I'm just showing now the way to check this guy is that when you drive the car at about 15 kilometers per hour, when you reach it first time after turning the engine on, it will just have a small crank noise in the front of the engine. That's the ABS checking, and you need to perform that in order for this computer to read that code. So let's just try the car, and up to maybe 15 kilometers per hour, that's about 10 miles per hour or so, let's just accelerate a little bit, and you will notice at that point you will see if there is a code or not. Okay, I did have my STC slipping a little bit because my wheels were on ice, but like I said, you notice that once I did reach that speed, small computer could was able actually to read if there is a code or not for the BCM brake control module. So this is pretty much it. Sorry, it was a little bit lengthy. Lengthy video, and also my camera got off focus, but yeah, this is it. Check the video description. I'll put maybe the modules that you want to check in the first place. Some of them are important, other are perhaps less important. I will also mention the all-wheel driving cars. The all-wheel driving system had a lot of problems up to 2007. There's a electronic module DEM, which is very important. You don't have a code on it, otherwise that module, it's very, very expensive and will make the car undrivable when it gets corrosion inside. So yes, this is just a quick check, actually more or less a quick check, but I think it's an important check when you try to buy a new car, a used car, a used Volvo, and may save you money and may also help you negotiate a little bit the price. Thanks for watching, guys.